2 years since Operation Shuja was launched, life is slowly going back to normal in some parts of the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo. But despite the success registered, there are still challenges the forces are facing as they pursue ADF rebels. A few Congolese traders are seen riding especially motorcycles as they maneuver through the bad roads. Last month, the Operation Shuja entered its fourth phase and established its tactical headquarters at Luna in Ituri province. Major General Dick Olum, the Operation Shuja overall commander, told the news that they recently opened up a Sector 4 of the operation, which covers areas of Beni, Oicha, Eringet, Ndimo up to Komanda in Ituri province. Although joint forces have already been deployed in all those areas, General Olum says the poor road network to ensure frequent military and food supplies to the soldiers remains a challenge.
The challenges that we get in this mission is the poor state of the road networks. The challenge is if that is done, if we can patch up these worst places, then we are sure we can supply, we can take our soldiers wherever we want.
I see where we're almost getting stuck there. That was a ditch, a very big ditch, almost 3 meters deep. So we have just brought soil in, but still it's not yet compacted.
Despite not being professional in road construction, the soldiers on the mission have now embarked on the rehabilitation of the 75-kilometer road from Luna through Katebe in Ndalia, Mambelega, Ndimo, up to Komanda, as General Olum explains.
Through Katebe, through Ndalia, Ndalia to Mambelenga, Mambelenga to Ndimo, Ndimo to Ido, Ido to Manzobe, Manzobe to Komanda. Over 75 kilometers, quite a long stretch. As you have seen, where we have passed is not so bad as you see here. So we are extremely pleased with the little knowledge we have, but we are doing a great job. All I want to do is, can we patch a part of road so that our trucks can take food for us?
General Loom has, however, decried the lack of enough road equipment to enable the work on the 75-kilometer stretch within a short time.
Bulldozer, one bucket loader, one grader, one compactor, and one excavator. They are not enough. To work on a road which is 75 kilometers, they are not enough. Even if I'm not working on the road, even if I'm still patching the spoiled areas, those equipments are very, very few.
In situations where roads are not passable at all, General Olum says the UPDF leadership uses air transport to deliver supplies and to also evacuate some of the injured soldiers.
Once the road is also so difficult to reach to where our soldiers are, we end up using the air means, helicopter. And the supply by air is extremely, extremely expensive. But in most cases, the leadership of the UPDF have nothing to do. We have to use the helicopters to ensure these troops are fed, are supplied with logistics and any other requirements. And this also relates to any soldier who would get sick or injured during the course of his operation. So would carry these soldiers also by the use of these helicopters.
ADF began activities in Uganda, but was forced into the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, where it is best. It carries out deadly attacks in villages near the borders and is accused of killing thousands of people in both countries since pledging allegiance to IS in 2019. A joint ground and air operation by Uganda and Congo was set up in 2021, and since then, at least 550 militants have been killed. Report compiled by Rogers Sunday for the news.